thought, if I'm going to do this, I can't, I don't have time to reason this out. I just have to go.
What would you do? Your home is on fire, the smoke is thick, and your two small children are crying for help. Only on 12 Tonight, a West Allis father talks about risking it all to save his two sons. Good evening, I'm Mike Miller. Shelby's off. It could have ended very badly, but a local father is alive tonight, and so are his children. 12 News' Brendan Conway has the incredible rescue in a story you'll see only on 12.
It went straight from sleeping into a nightmare.
Jay Brunson woke up Saturday morning to the sounds of his two-year-old son Kyle screaming for help. He didn't know it at the time, but over the next few minutes, Brunson would use every ounce of strength and bravery to save his family's life from their burning West Allis home.
I realized real quickly there was something wrong because I started hearing this rumbling.
Without thinking, Brunson's instincts kicked in. Through the blinding smoke, he found his youngest son by the bottom of the stairs and carried him outside. In the middle of the confusion and darkness, Brunson thought it was the middle of the night until he opened his back door.
It was like I stepped into another world. It was bright light outside and white, you know, the snow.
The relief of being outside was quickly replaced by the horror that his four-year-old son Owen was still inside.
I thought, if I'm going to do this, I can't, I don't have time to reason this out. I just have to go.
Blinded by the smoke and burning in the growing heat, Brunson ran up the stairs to Owen's room.
It was just so full that it was burning my lungs and my throat, and I knew if I took in another breath or two, I may not be coming out of there. When I pushed open the door, I grabbed his wrist, and in that breath, I said, run. And I don't know whether his feet even touched the floor, because I was already taking him down the stairs.
Once they were outside, Brunson had one more hurdle, getting them free from the burning house. Wearing only his boxer shorts, he broke through their side gate and carried his boys one by one to safety.
Ran back through the gate, got down to the sidewalk, and just pretty much collapsed on the fire chief.
Jay's wife Carol was at work when the fire broke out. She says Jay gave her the best Valentine's Day gift ever.
If he didn't wake up, I would not have my family today.
Both the boys are doing fine tonight. Jay was kept in the hospital overnight because of smoke inhalation, but he is expected to be okay. The cause of this fire is still undetermined, but the Brunsons say it looks like it started in their bedroom. Amazingly, Mike, Jay was not sleeping in the bed. He usually does, but he actually had fallen asleep for some reason on the couch. That probably saved his life because
very
of this.
Very lucky. And there's been a big outpouring of support for them.
They lost everything in this fire. House pretty much needs to be totaled. That they say nurses at the hospital, neighbors have stepped forward donating clothes and toiletries, and they're happy for that.
All right, Brendan, thanks.